Today I'm going to explain what a constant current source is, and show you how to use one to safely power LEDs and laser diodes. This video builds upon material I covered in my voltage regulator tutorials, so make sure you've watched those first. Most of the time in electronics, you'll find yourself working with constant voltage sources. Wall warts, voltage regulators, and other types of power supplies can all have small variations in voltage, but they're basically constant voltage sources. So, what's a constant current source? Well, as the name implies, it's a circuit that creates a constant current regardless of what the load is. This is the schematic symbol of a current source connected to a resistor. If you have an ideal 1 amp constant current source, it doesn't matter if you connect it to a 1 ohm resistor or a 100 ohm resistor, it'll always shove 1 amp through that resistor. Don't want to use a resistor? Put an LED in the circuit, and regardless of what color the LED is, it'll push an amp through the LED. This may or may not be a good thing, depending on how much current your load can handle. Certain devices, like high-powered LEDs, are best used when they're fed a constant current, because they'll maintain the same brightness regardless of how much they heat up. You could also use a constant current source to drive a string of LEDs in series. Here I have a 12 milliamp constant current source I built, and it doesn't matter how many LEDs I put on it, they all get 12 milliamps. So, how do we build this? Well, the easiest way to build a constant current source is using an LM317. I'll put a link in the video description section. Here's the circuit diagram. It's very simple. You connect your power source to the input pin, and then you have a resistor between the output and the adjustment pins on the LM317. A pair of 10 microfarad capacitors will help stabilize the current source during sudden load changes. The value of the resistor determines what the constant current will be. In the example I showed you, I used a 100 ohm resistor, which gave me a theoretical current value of 12.5 milliamps. Now let's see what we're getting in real life. Here I'm pushing 12.6 milliamps through an LED. If I add another LED, I still get 12.6 milliamps. Let's add a laser diode to switch things up. It doesn't matter what the load is, the current stays the same. And the other cool thing is that even if the input voltage increases to 24 volts, the current stays constant. The input voltage is still important though. If we go from 12 volts down to 5 volts, we no longer have enough voltage to turn on all the LEDs. You need to make sure that the input voltage is at least 2 volts higher than what the load requires to overcome the dropout voltage issue. I explained this in more detail in my video about voltage regulators. Now, how does all this magic work? Isn't the LM317 supposed to be an adjustable voltage regulator? Well, it is, but we're using a special trick to make it behave like a constant current source. Inside the LM317 is some special circuitry that creates a feedback loop. This feedback loop is set up to maintain a difference of 1.25 volts between the adjust pin and the output pin. If the input voltage suddenly changes, it doesn't matter. The LM317 quickly adjusts the output voltage to maintain the difference of 1.25 volts between the adjust pin and the output. If the load changes, again, it doesn't matter. The LM317 reacts and maintains the 1.25 volt difference. You can use this behavior to build an adjustable voltage source, or you can use it to build an adjustable current source. This equation is basically Ohm's law. Volts divided by resistance equals current. And since you know the LM317 is giving you a 1.25 volt difference, by changing the resistor value, you can choose the current. Now, there's one more thing you should know about. The LM317 is a linear voltage regulator, and our current is passing through a relatively large resistance value. In other words, this design is not very efficient. I wouldn't recommend using it for currents higher than 200 milliamps, otherwise your components are going to get really hot. If you want more current, search for switch mode constant current supply designs, or visit Amazon for a pre-made solution. Thank you for watching, and check out my other videos if you want to learn more about electronics.